Hi, this is TapCat. Welcome to part 31 of Let's Play XCOM 2. We're about to go on a pretty significant mission. I think what I want to do, since we know from the Shadow Chamber intel, there's going to be a lot of robotic enemies there. So I think I'm going to bring blue screen rounds. I haven't had a chance to use these before. Hopefully we'll be happy with them. I am a little anxious about it. Now I assume I have to do this, right? Well, in that case, extinguishes or blocks any mental impairments from themselves or teammates. All right, I'll do that. Now I think I may just let that sit for a little bit. I thought when we got this last installment, I didn't have a choice, but we can get our soldiers back. We can get our supplies. Kind of like that. So, yeah, see, I got money now. What's this look like? 120 intel. See, I'm not so into that. That's a lot. So could we build a tower here? Wow, it costs 100. Criminy, what do you people take me for? Okay, let's see. If I'm reading this right, I think, how can I tell? Okay, so this is the only one I've actually built, it looks like. Does that mean it would cost 108? No, it would cost us 100. But we'd get 108. Oh, so it would be 36 more. All right, well, that's a little weak. Cost me 80 to do that. Well, you know what? I'm probably being like a little bit ridiculous right now. How many days do I need to get Amber out of the hospital? Because really, that's probably the only thing that I would really like. I need 2 days. So realistically, what could we do in 2 days, you know, that would matter? I could always just do a little more scanning. That's a thing. I could start a tower, but we don't have so much money. Where is that base, just out of curiosity? The one that, okay, it's in the Western U.S., you know what I could do is I could come over here and start working on that, because increasing that region's income doesn't sound like a bad idea to me. Now, we haven't made contact really over here, but, you know, we could later.
I have made a number of interesting discoveries, Commander.
I don't believe there's any other research he can do. Yeah, no, that's it. Okay.
The coordinates we discovered encoded on the genetic.
So we didn't get a ton of intel, but we got a little. Okay, that's it. We got Amber. So I don't think waiting is a good idea. Like, what am I going to accomplish? So let's just go.
Setting course for Western United States.
I guess what I should do first is I want to buy some stuff, so I'm probably going to just remove Abby. I definitely want to get rid of the Talon rounds from her loadout. And what I want to do before I go any farther, I'm going to buy her some stuff. We're going to buy a couple of things, actually. So number one, this has been a long time coming, but I'm getting the frickin' fusion thing. And then I'm gonna get the hell weave too. So this is kind of my plan for her. I'm gonna give her the hell weave. And then she's got the fusion blade, and that should make her just awesome against anyone who attacks her, you know, physically, the melee attack. Now, Paladin, he's going to take the Talon rounds. So that's a done deal. I know I want Julie in here. It kind of sucks that Django is shaken, but I think I'm going to give him... maybe I'll give those to her. Hold on. Because she's not shaken. So she should have a better chance to hit. Okay. I'm actually kind of tempted to bring an acid grenade for greater armor melting purposes. Do I wish to do that? I think... Oh, she's already got one. Oh, no, she doesn't. I see. The EMP grenades didn't impress me as much as I was hoping they would. Well, you know what? I think I'm just going to stick with the plasma are so good all the way around. Okay, are we ready? I want Doc for sure. I want him. I want her. I want him. Yeah. You know, I wish I could bring Abby. I just don't want to leave any of these guys behind. So we're going. We're going to go to this special black site and try and shut down this sick operation they've got going.
Facility, most likely tied to that stuff we found at the black site. Advent and the alien forces won't be happy to see us, so expect heavy resistance. We have to do whatever it takes to find out what's going on in there.
Okay. Well, if we're going into the wilderness of the western U.S., my gunslinger should be very comfortable there.
Facility is in range. Move to investigate.
The Forge. The Forge. See, that suggests it's a place where they manufacture munitions. That's what it suggests to me. I suppose it doesn't have to be munitions. Okay, I'm going to try to spread out a little bit here. See what we can see while we're concealed. All right, if they can't see Paladin where he is, they shouldn't be able to see him here. I mean, there is some possibility of, you know, aliens over this way, so I don't want to get too aggressive about going over that way. Let's move Julie next. And is this the edge of the map? It is. So I don't really need to worry about getting flanked there. But I feel like if I come over here, it's just very unlikely that she'll be close enough to do anything. So I'll come here.
Affirmative, moving out.
Okay, so there's nobody over there. So what I think I'll do then is I will move Django here. He would be vulnerable to flanking if there was somebody, you know, over here, but... All right, we're not moving forward anymore, so just so I don't have to cycle through all of this. And I think I'll just move him here. We kind of have the team split in half. Yeah. Let's see. Is it worth moving him? I don't think that it is. I don't think there's a high risk of moving him forward, but... Okay, I hear a sectopod, which we kind of know already is here. I could move him here. I don't have a lot of options, honestly, if I want to stay behind cover. I could move, you know, up here if I wanted to. That's not necessarily a bad idea before we give up.
Enemy squad located.
So we got two advanced mechs, right? Heavy mech. Okay. And he doesn't have a great chance to hit either. I think, you know what I want, realistically? I shouldn't have both of my grenadiers in one side. It makes a lot more sense to have one in each of the two groups. I mean, I'm not even sure I'm going to keep it as two distinct groups, but... And then I think what I'll do is I'll just move him back here and kind of clear that space for her next turn. And that way he'll have all of his movement available next turn. And the thing that's rough here is there's so few spots with real cover. See, and I don't want to use him as a long-range sniper, and I feel like this setup, that's what I'm going to get stuck doing. And, if I'm going to do that, where's the best place to even stand? Do I come, like, here? Ugh. All right, let's hold off. So, I don't think I want to stay up here with all of these guys. There's too little cover. Yep, this is a good spot. This is a good spot. It should help reveal if there's anything nearby, and at the same time, it gave him cover from both directions. So, okay. So we're going to start putting these guys on Overwatch because I'm not sending anybody else down closer. I think I will move her here because it's becoming apparent to me that there's not anything to see on this side. And I'd rather just... Yeah, as much as it kind of galls me... I think I'm going to bring him here. That'll probably give him the best angles and keep him out of their firing range. And he won't take up one of the precious cover spots in that tight area. I'll also present a little less of a grenade target. So that's good too. Okay, so... Could Julie or Django... hit these guys? Yes. So we would shred armor. We will cause falling damage. I think that is well worth doing. They each only have two grenades, so it doesn't really matter which one I use first. And it looks like I don't have a choice anyway. So I'm thinking I will put her on Overwatch. Now, you know, he has run and gun, so I could just hold him open. I think I will. At this range, his shotgun equivalent is really not going to be very good.
Eyes on the prize.
Who else we got? Yep, definitely Overwatch.
I'm on it.
And Django's actually going to get the party started. So she is another one that I might be better off just trying to go in and get closer. But I am a little worried about that. I think I will, though. Let me try this. Can I... that could be dangerous, actually. I was going to say, can I bring Django here?
That's affirmative.
If I reveal somebody else... Okay, Twitch and Paladin, you're the only other ones. We're going. Right now, let's see what happens. Hey, those aren't supply crates, are they? Can I possibly do this without trashing them? Yes, I can. Okay. Just in case, I don't want to diminish. Oh, I guess they... Nah, I didn't need to worry about it. Because they tell you how many supplies you're going to get. Yep, that was a bad call. So now this guy took no falling damage. Actually, maybe it's not bad. Because he also is up where we can see him. Don't know if that's good or not. Yeah, see, like, he can't even see the other one. Wait, so they're not moving? Am I the only one who thinks that's weird? Because I think it's weird. Okay, so... wow. That's great. So I can come here and take a fairly crap shot. Okay. Wow. This is dicey, but I'm going to do it. What could go wrong? Never, ever say that, by the way. Let's see what happens. Okay. I'm going to try rupture because, well, maybe that's a little extreme. It is. If I hit him, I'm going to kill him, I think. I didn't hit him anyway, so. No point wasting all that ammo.
Yeah, I didn't get it.
Yeah, it was a good shot. I mean, I think it was well worth the try. It is pretty aggravating. I didn't get anything out of it. Honestly, I think I'm just going to do this. When they move, I already have a bunch of people on Overwatch. So, you know, we could have gotten a good start on it. This is definitely not a good opening for us. It's a bit crap, to be honest. Could have done without that. Yep, not going to lie. Could have done without that. It's weird. It looks like he's already hurt one bar. Okay, Julie, make me proud. That actually did. Good girl. Oh, that's awesome. That's really helpful. So now this guy. Oh, he didn't move, the frickin' weasel. Okay.
Fire's getting close here. I'm getting burned.
Oh, hell, she's on fire. Okay. Well, I can step up here, but, you know, honestly, it's just not very good. So let's leave him aside for just a moment. So I could come here and see if I could get a good shot, but I mean, Doc is just not really what I need in this situation. Okay, since he can't hit Mr. Sectopod, although I might be able to... Oh, wait. No, he's not on Overwatch. He's not on Overwatch. At least I don't think he is. Does this symbol mean he's on Overwatch? I thought it had a little eye. I don't know. This is kind of scary. Well, I could bring her over here and use rupture. I mean, ooh, that's risky. I mean, if I don't kill him, what's going to happen to her? I feel like I need to lead with explosives somehow. But we're not going to vaporize this no matter what we do. So, okay, let me just do this. Let's see what we can do to this mech. Okay, that's not bad. That's not bad. Why did it have to be the frickin' sectopod? Who did we give? We gave Django the blue screen round. No, we didn't. We gave it to Julie. I remember now. Yep, that's not great in this circumstance. I could come here. Can she hit him from there? Better hope so.
Sure thing.
At least we're getting her away from the fire. Wait. Okay. She can't see him. Damn it. Okay, well, if that's the case, then I may just bring her here so that she's ready for next turn.
Absolutely.
You know, we can actually have her fire at the guy. All right, I keep having this pull back. So he only has a 55% chance at that. Doc is a much better shot, and I am thinking I'm going to take that, but can I, well, I'm not going to worry about her right now. Let's just try and kill this guy. All right, we got him. That's pretty important. So now I can move the other ones up more easily. And try to deal with that ridiculous creature known as a sectopod. But, I mean, easily is a very relative term here. Because he's got full cover. That's what I just hate. But you know what? I just got my answer. All right. I'm going to bring him back. If the thing has Overwatch, he's got it. Turns out he doesn't. What would I get with Chain Shot? Actually, that's not bad. 75% if I did this. Should I? Should I just do that? I don't think so. I feel like we need to hit him. Shred that armor. Okay.
Hit the armor.
So this to me is where things start getting interesting. Because see, I could move her up and do rupture. I could hit this guy hard, but if I don't kill him, I'm really screwing her over. Yeah, you know what? I'm not gonna. We're gonna try and pull him forward, and next turn, we'll go after him. So, I'm going to, do I want to go behind half cover? Because that's kind of what I'm looking at here. Unless I come here. I'm going to do that.
Whatever you say.
sucks because it means I won't get Overwatch. I mean, I'll put him on Overwatch. Actually, I'm not even gonna. I'm just gonna reload him. He has 0% chance of seeing that thing this turn. That was a good shot. He damn near killed her. Oh my god, the fire. Is she gonna die? That was good. Well, this thing's gonna die this turn. I think I can promise you that. Yeah, you go on Overwatch. Yep, I was afraid of that.
Evac! We need emergency evac!
Oh, Django. Why did you have to be a moron? Okay, well, here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to come over here.
No problem, boss.
And, yeah, I have a really good chance. But I can't, right. Well, let's do this. I'm not going to... I'm just not going to allow that to happen.
Gremlin, get on the
hill. Let's just say it. Okay. So. Yeah. I actually want her to fire this turn. I want to know what these EMP rounds do. And my intent is we're killing this thing now. So the bad thing is I can't move because of Overwatch. So does she get a turn? She does. And she has 100% chance. So here we go. We're going to find out what this thing does. That's interesting. It lowered its hacking defenses. So, I mean, that's not really going to, you know, help us right now. That's very interesting. All right. You know what I'm going to do? I'm going to kill him with Slash. No, I'm not. No, I'm not. You know why? Because he does explosive damage when you're standing next to him. In fact, please tell me she's far enough back that she won't take it anyway.
You can't handle me. I'm running low on
ammo.
He's
a badass. Okay, I'm going to get him down here. And I'll reload him. I was tempted to just, what's it called? Overwatch. I will put him on Overwatch. I'm not moving forward whatsoever. Yeah, that symbol. Somebody told me recently that you'll see that symbol if they're on Overwatch. Okay, so Django is still kind of wussing out. So I'm just going to reload. I'm going to let him have his moment, you know.
I'm on it.
I'm not going to move forward at all. And then I'm going to use a heal on her. Because we need to. She's way too important for me to allow her to die. Okay, so that helped. And then I'll reload. Okay. I'll put him on Overwatch. Well, actually, before I do that, I want him closer, so I just don't want to reveal anybody, so that's fine. I'll just come here.
Running.
Okay. And, reload. And, Overwatch. Oh, wait. Crap. We're not going to get that stuff. I can't get to it. I forgot all about it. When I saw it drop, I was like, oh, I got to try to get up there if I can. But it wasn't easy to get up to because there was no ladder down here for us. I think I might have blown that up. It required like going a long way around. So, yeah. And then when I remembered, it was just too late. So that's unfortunate. Yeah, I don't think I can find any more excuses to not move up. So let's see what we got. Okay, she doesn't see anything. This is a little ugly. You know, I can't really get to anything.
Seems doable.
That's cover. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to keep him right there. I know that may seem a little goofy, but we're just gonna like move up behind him in a line. So I just kind of want to walk ground we've already covered here, and that way it should be impossible to reveal anybody. We'll make a little forward progress and just go on Overwatch. So if somebody does step up, we'll make them pay, but then we'll have to scramble to get behind cover. That would be the bad part, but we could put an awful big dent, though, in almost anything if we hit. If we play the miss game, not so much. Okay. Okay, so I could move her up, but I think it's pretty obvious that the stuff we have to worry about is over that way.
I'm going.
Okay, so he didn't see anything. Can I could get him here, but there's no cover, so that's awesome. But I could like bring him here. Okay. Yeah, this is... I'll move him here. It should, again, be impossible for anybody to see him.
Sure thing.
Okay.
Let's do this.
I'm just going to be very conservative. We don't have any kind of time limit.
On Overwatch.
And why act like I'm on a short clock? I'll go ahead and move her or him forward. No one can see him there, so that should be fine.
I'm on it.
Okay. Oh, wait. He is low on ammo. Right. When I was reloading everyone, he was panicked. So that's fine. She's the only one left. Okay. Yep. Anything? It's raining debris. But other than that, nothing's going on. So it's across that bridge. I see. Whatever we're hearing. I hate that she's one short of being able to do that. But, hey. Anything? Nope. Okay. Well, I don't... Wait a second. Oh, he can't go out. That's horrible. Okay, I completely screwed that up because I thought I would be able to just jump out through these windows. I guess it's supposed to be like a laser grid. So we're just going to waste this turn now. I kind of came in here for nothing. Okay, I think this is safe, but what I should do is move Julie there.
Not a problem.
And since I can at least have one soldier on Overwatch, put Doc there. I could leave him there, but once again, like, is that why I gotta? All right, I'll tell you what. I'm gonna bring him up here. Okay. Django. Yeah, seriously, this gets harder and harder. Like, where am I supposed to move, guys? I'll just come here.
On your order.
Up a little bit. Don't want to take a chance. All right, come on. Come on.
Movement here.
Step up. Because we actually have decent cover. I don't want to lose that. Let me do this.
Let's move already.
No. Honestly, I was hoping I'd reveal him. I really was. Like, I'm kind of ready at this point. And I could come here, and there's very little chance. If this doesn't reveal it, there's a very good chance this won't either. Am I going to take that chance? No, I am not. Because it's reckless and foolish. Again, moving behind her is one thing. But breaking new ground? Mm-mm.
Got it covered.
No, that's not smart. So I am going to put her on Overwatch, and I'm going to put him on Overwatch, because no one is going to move forward of those two positions. I'm going to put him on Overwatch. I think I'll just move Doc here.
Move into position.
And I'll put him on Overwatch. And I'll put her on Overwatch. And I'm guessing we aren't going to see anything at all. We didn't. Okay. I am now going to move him forward. All right, I got nothing. I don't want to frustrate people. But I want to move forward with him, not her. Because he has more range. So, I'm going to give that extra Overwatch. Just so I can do that. Okay. I'll come here. Oh my god, I did that. I thought I had him, and I didn't. So, that sucks. Okay. It's not the end of the world. Okay. So, I'm not going to move back with her yet. I don't have a lot of good shots here, but he does. So, if I shoot at that guy, I can't kill him. He'll split, of course, if I hit. The thing is, like, two codexes with one hit point each. I don't know. I don't think that's the worst thing ever. They can't have more than two if I hit. So, I think that this is fine. And actually, the funny thing is, when it's, well, it didn't split anyway. I was gonna say, if it splits, one of them could appear closer to us, and that might actually be better for me, you know. Crap. Yeah, I'm actually not happy with her options. She's going to have to come here. Well, honestly, with these two hit chances, I think that the best thing I can do, arguably, he can't even see any of these guys. I can't get a grenade over there, so I'm doing some Overwatches here. Not her. Yeah. You know what I am going to do? I'm going to save him. I'm going to use aid protocol. We don't use it a lot, but I think in this instance, it could really come in handy. Okay. So she's going to come back in this corner. For some reason, it didn't want to do it. And now I'll do aid protocol. No. Yeah. Yep, let's help her out. And then I believe I can still go on Overwatch. Okay, let's see what happens. So yeah, this guy should take some damage. It would have been nice if one of the grenadiers would have shredded him before that. Let's see if he can do it. No, but he did a point. God, I thought he was going to jump into the abyss. Okay, you freaking aliens. It's my turn now. This is going to be awkward, though. Make no mistake. Now, that guy has definitely left himself vulnerable. And, okay, so can't do anything with his rifle. So Django, I just have like no chance to hit virtually any of these guys. So I'll tell you what, I feel like using a grenade here, this isn't bad. We'll split them, but oh boy, I'd have to get Twitch out of there. Hold on. I'm not positive when it would blow up, and I really don't want to get her killed. So, wowza. Maybe I should just bring her here and beat the hell out of this guy. What does Reaper do again? Oh, right. But I won't get a kill. Not on him. I'm more likely to get a kill with Rupture. But boy, if I let's do this. Let me just get her away. Oh, thank God. I thought it was a group. Okay. Now, come back to Django. If I do this, I can actually, I'm not sure I can. And you know, in all honesty, I don't really want to use explosives on one of the few opponents that doesn't even have what's the word I'm trying to use? Armor. Okay, if I open up on this thing, she probably will kill it. I'm going to do this. Yep.
Woo! You see that?
So now I did that in part because I'm also willing to do this. This is so bad though. I kind of was counting on him to take out this guy. he has a crap chance. And those two can't do anything. So Django is literally the only other one who can do anything against that jackass. Okay, here's what I'm going to do. I am going to move here. This is super risky. Not recommended whatsoever. I'm just going to open up on this thing. Should be able to kill it. Yep. Okay. I am. Oh, that's so awesome. Okay. I'm going to save that. Now, actually, I'm going to use Doc to heal him. We're going through our heals, man.
Healer mode.
Okay. So now, I'm thinking I'll move him here. Maybe I'll be ready to do something next turn with the handgun. Alternatively, I could move Django. I think that's what I'm going to do. I'm going to move Django here. Because my goal is to see if we can't... really? 44%? Alright, hail a bullets time. We got some shredding to do. Yeah, we didn't kill him, but he's pretty messed up. Okay. So, I think this is a good spot. Very low chance of revealing a new enemy. It's full cover. Pretty much impossible to flank. Now, he cannot see that guy. I'm really tempted to just heal Julie, I gotta be honest. But on the off chance that that thing moves up, I'll do this.
Covering now.
So, Mike, what am I going to do with you? I'll bring him here. I was really tempted to bring her there, but with her health where it is, I'm not sure that's a good plan. So now the question is, where should I move her? And I think I'll move her here.
Location confirmed.
Okay. So what's he going to do? He's going to run like a coward. You know, I don't know why I never expect the aliens to do that. Even though at this point they've pretty well established that behavior. Okay, I'm going to do this. I'm going to move her here.
Here I come.
And I cannot see that guy. Pretty sure we're just going to do a quick reload this turn. But what I'm going to do, I want to try and get these other guys across the bridge. I'll just bring him here.
Got it.
So, yeah. I mean, you could try to get cute and, like, have somebody, like, especially if you have a long-range sniper type, you know, like, you could try to come over here. Stay out of sight, but maybe be ready to fire, you know, but you get a different angle. That would be the big benefit. Actually, this isn't a terrible spot. I'm starting to wonder if I should have brought Inez on this mission instead of him. Maybe.
Overwatch.
It's always hard to know because you don't know what the lay of the land is going to be. Okay.
Reloaded.
I'll just bring him as far as I can. Come on.
On the move.
Oh, Let's do the obvious. And, yeah, sadly, I just can't come very far. Oh. Okay, well, I didn't really expect them to come looking for us, because that, like, never happens, it seems like. Okay.
It's still moving.
Yes, it is. So, it was a small group. Having the Archon and the Andromedan together is a little rough, but the reality is, you know, we have made a pretty good start on the first, I don't know what you call it, incarnation, life of the Andromedan. So, let's do this. Let me come get Mike first. He's got an 81% and a 67%. Now, I do have lightning hands up, and I definitely want to take that. I don't have as good a chance, but I don't think that's a reason to not try. All right, I mean, this guy has a ton of health, even two. It'll help. Battle frenzy, yeah, whatever. Okay, and we'll go ahead and take this shot. This could go a long way to nothing. Yep.
Target's still up.
Okay. Yeah. This is just awkward. Having so many. I kind of want to bring her, like, you know, here. She still won't have a true flank on that guy, though. Django. I could move him here. I'm not even positive I need to move him. I could blast both of these guys, and that is not terrible. Yeah, because I don't have a good shot. I could move here. I think I will.
On your order.
I don't see any harm in it. I might actually get like a good chain shot. No, I only have 49%. That's my best shot. So I'm going to do this. It'll break up cover for the Andromedan. It'll get rid of the last of his armor. It won't quite kill him, which sucks. Hold on. Julie gets a bonus, doesn't she, on explosives? Let me check this.
Absolutely.
She actually has a better chance. I think his is bad, like really bad, because he's shaken. But I'm going to do this. Okay, that's as far as I can go back. I wanted to try and bust up the cover at least to the other one, but... Oh, okay, here we go. Make sure I don't lose the spot. So maybe she'll even get the first kill on the Andromedan. Nope, that's all right. It's all good. He doesn't have cover anymore. Yep, battle frenzy. That's okay. I'm going to give him somebody to shoot at that he doesn't really want to shoot at, if I can. Doc has a 70% chance on that guy from here? That's pretty good. I'm going to move up.
Confirmed.
And I'm going to take that shot. Up to 75 now. Do your thing, man. Do it well. Oh, my God. So that's an 81 and a 75 that I've missed. Those are only two shots I've taken. You know, I don't want to complain. I just would like to make a shot here at some point. Because this is kind of rough. The guy I have the best chance at by far is one that only needs 3 points of damage. I can't really use chain shot. It would take it down 15 points. You know what I feel like I need to do is that, but actually I don't. I think this is the least important guy to kill in a way, because he's going to do a melee attack, and I intend to move Paladin up here and make him a target, or Amber. So who have I got left besides that? I got Django, and that's it. I just have those three. Okay. I am going to use him here. This is just rough because this guy really needs to die too. Okay. But I got an idea. I actually have a really good idea. I don't often get those. But I think this will work. I have Untouchable. Oh, so only the next attack against him will miss. But he's really good against melee attacks usually to begin with. So what I'm going to do, I'm really anxious about revealing another group, but I'm thinking I use run and gun and I come here. Let me do this first. I have one space to spare. Boy, that sucks. All right, I'm going to come here. And if I were to kill him, I only have a 74% chance. Oh, I need to use run and gun. I just don't want to get any closer. I really don't. Cover is so worthless. Just go and don't reveal yourself. Oh, thank God. Okay. I have 100% chance and I'm going to do this. That brings it down to 95, but I think we got this. Okay. Good deal. Good deal.
Not too shabby.
We get a free move, but I don't want one yet. Now I do need to decide how to use her here. And she doesn't have his little double whammy. 7 and 9, it's just not likely to kill either one of these guys. So I think the shotgun. Is more likely to matter. Okay, I'm going for the one I know I can hit. That's really what it comes down to. So what I'm counting on here is that the Rangers generally dodge melee attacks. And he literally gets a free shot. Like, they cannot hit him once because I got that kill. So I'm setting them up to be crash test dummies, in a sense. So there you go. There's Untouchable. And then I'm just counting on them to dodge the one from the Andromedan. Plus, there was this. So, it worked.
Who's keeping score?
And now, you know, the whole team can just tee up this guy. So, I feel like, you know, we got a really good chance here. I don't really need to. I only have a 20% chance of getting the kill, but nonetheless, let's go ahead and use the sword again. I paid all that money for the fancy blade. So that's not bad. Now he's already, you know, a colonel, so let's not fool with that. Where's He has an 81% chance. But he's also the one I'd most like to move up. So how about, wow, 64%. You are a stud, buddy. I'm just going to move closer. And I'm going to try to shoot him. That's kind of what this comes down to. And if nothing else, you know, they got the holo targeting on there. These things do have really good defense. And Doc can literally not even see him. I think that stone is tall enough that it blocks him. So that's fine. Let's just try to get him this kill and be done. Oh, God. Yeah, you didn't get it. I have a guaranteed kill with Paladin, but let's see. We got Mike and Julie, so
not a problem.
I'd really like to just do this on somebody who can get a promotion. All right. And now I can just move Mike forward, which is what I wanted to do.
What did you expect?
Yeah, she gets to move. Thing is, honestly, I don't even want to. I don't want to move forward at all. So you can move forward, because this ground is well trod. Oh, brother. I love that he's, like, stuck down here. I'm going to reload him. I don't know if we'll even need that much ammo for the rest of the mission, but that's fine. I hear another sectopod out there. All right, so nobody came knocking. So now we're going to kind of get out from the middle of the open ground. And while I am going to move forward a bit, I am very much hoping that we don't reveal anybody, and I am going to be pretty cautious about where I go. Okay. Yeah, and I'm going to reload anyone who needs it. Okay. That's not actually what I meant to do. Go ahead and move up. Now, that was kind of stupid because I left him out of cover, and I do want him in cover, but I also want to reload, so I'm going to prioritize that. Django. Yeah, it's fine. Just come here and reload.
On the move.
I don't think that there's going to be anything else out patrolling. By my count, if I remember right, we were told when we were looking in the Shadow Chamber there were going to be 14 aliens. I believe 6 are left.
Ready to engage.
Well, never mind.
I've got eyes on advent troops.
I was just going to say, I think they're going to be in the facility, and they are. I just didn't realize they would see us from where we are and where they are. That's okay. I'm not really too fussed about that. It's not necessarily the ideal way to find him, but I'm not really too bothered either. Probably the one thing I'm really unhappy with, though, is Julie's health and the fact that she's behind half cover, and there's very little of anything but half cover. That's probably my bigger concern. I'm actually wondering if we shouldn't come back. Is there a ladder over there? Yep, they could come up. All right. I was just thinking, if I went up here, you know, would that work? But I was thinking about this ladder, like Doc or somebody like that. Yeah, I'm not happy that this is how we got revealed. I think what I want to do is like come way over here, because it should be impossible for them to get a good shot at me. So here's what I'm going to do. I'll come here as a middle ground.
Whatever you say.
These aren't civilians. They're Advent.
Yes. And judging by the subject's condition, I would say it was recently manufactured. No wonder they just keep coming.
Okay. Okay. Come in here, as promised.
Seems doable.
Now, there was a risk, you know, if someone had been over here. I just don't think so. I think there's this group, and I think there'll be somebody else somewhere in that vicinity, and that's who's left. That's what I think. And if I'm wrong, then it's really going to suck to be wrong. So I think I want Amber here. I really dislike that I'm not going to have a lot of good Overwatch shots, but kind of need to prioritize right now. I am going to heal her. And then I'm going to protect her by getting her behind real cover. Okay. Give me Julie. Thank you. You know what? I will bring her here, because I don't believe she can be flanked, and I'll at least get one potential good Overwatch shot. That's risky. I could bring him here. I just don't like how insanely two-dimensional our positions are lining up.
On your order.
Maybe that's not the right word, but I'm really in a position where I don't have good angles. You know, I have like one angle, period. I'll move him here. And I'll decide later. Maybe I'll go up on the roof, maybe I won't. It's just so easy for them to come up there. It doesn't feel great. But we'll have a few Overwatches here. And we should have a good chance to put a